So there are two versions. One, they are telling these are the dwellings for pygmy short guys. Another, they are telling this is a burial. Dead bodies used to keep here.
Here it is. Look at this and thank me later. Just watch. So here I have got down. Actually, I'm supposed to go to that hill. It has started raining now. I may have to take help of some villagers here, the local people. Villagers are offering me the chair as soon as I reach their place. This is the hospitality we receive in India. That's our duty, it seems. Thank you. This is really an amazing experience for me to see all this green fields, talking to villagers, looking at the mountain. So here I got my new guide for the day. What's your name?
Kumar.
Kumar. Look at me. This is not the raindrops on my face, but the sweat. It's really very humid. Before starting, understanding our megalithic past. So layers of civilization. So broken pots can tell you a story. That is what is written here. Digging for our own history. Megalithic site at Hirebenakal. This is one of Karnataka's largest megalithic sites. Resting places of the dead. This is turning interesting. So here we start our journey to climb this mountain.
Okay, what is this place?
This is called Hirebenakal.
Okay.
So according to my knowledge, it's more than 2000 years old settlements.
Mm-hmm.
Some are telling it's a dwellings of the ancient people.
Okay.
Some are telling they have burial, you know.
Okay.
Dead bodies have been kept.
It's built between 2000 and 3400 years ago. Many coincides with the Iron Age, but a few were built before the wide use of iron. A monument built 2800 to 2200. So I'm here now. I need to go all the way here to reach the quarry and the pond, which is about 1.5 hours journey, a trek. So this is the route. Wow, it's going to be very challenging now since it's raining. Very challenging, very steepy, very slippery. I'm damn exhausted. I'm completely exhausted now. I wonder if there are no wild animals here in this. Neolithic people, Navashilayagada Janaru. Oh, look at this. A timeline, 3000 BC. Neolithic period. And then 1000 BC, 500 BC, Ashoka's period. 180, 580. Yeah, complete timeline is here. And then Vijayanagara period. Look at the place. I was literally lost. This champ is quicker than me. I don't know how many times he has climbed up and down. He's running. I'm almost done. So I met a shepherd here. 60 arvatu illa idya. Great, adu oota na? Every day like bartira? Thank you, bye. He's a shepherd. He comes here every day. Imagine it. He has about 60 goats. There is one rock art here. Oh, yeah, I can see that on the rock. Rock art. Journey continues. Look at the tiredness on my face and look at the tiredness of this. I found a piece of drum over there.
That's a nagari.
Nagari, why are you using it? That's
a bare sound. Oh, bare
drum sound?
Drum set sound.
I can see small houses here. Like caves. Small houses built using the lamp, rock cuttings.
Here it is. Look at this and thank me later. Just watch. Wow.
We are saved by the blood, yo. Yeah, we are saved from nothingness. We are saved from the emptiness. Yeah, we are saved from darkness. We are saved by the blood, yo.
I had read this in books. Now I'm witnessing it. After the hardest climb, wow, look at this. That's nicely curved into round shape, into a circle. Oh, look at that guy, he's already there. Oh my god. Look at this.
Burial grounds, we are telling. More than 2000 years prehistoric. You can see a lot of houses, rock shelters here. But most of them damaged due to ignorance and negligence, local vandalism happened. So there are two versions. One, they are telling these are the dwellings for pygmy short guys. Another, they are telling this is a burial, dead bodies used to keep here. So two versions are there. That's again debatable, but not exactly not known till. Still, a research has to be happen on this location. Then only okay. We can come find out the truth. This is like some different region territory for them.
Yeah.
Only one tribal group, 150 houses are here.
Yeah.
That small group has been lived here. And water source, small water bodies, rainwater has started harvesting. You can see here and there.
I saw them.
Yeah.
There are lot many questions which are unanswered. I really don't have information to explain anything. So whatever I explored here, seeing these places around, I just have, this is my small effort to show you as well, whatever I am experiencing, maybe a bit of it you can experience watching this video. That is all I wanted. Just share your opinion watching this video, maybe you can comment. If you would like to visit such amazing location or if you have something around you, please drop me a comment so that I can try visiting it. This is Shiv here from Masala Chai Media India, signing off. Bye bye. After having about 11,462 steps and about 8.02 kilometers walk, I would like to thank Mr. Kumar. Kumar, he helped me to have this amazing experience. Thank you, Kumar.